Strat-O-Matic Excel Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Troll.
Game 164, Reds at Pirates.
Welcome back, baseball fans. 1972-75 Carryover League. We got a best of seven series in the National League today between two of the heavyweights in this timeline, the Reds Pirates. Winners of the last two World Series, as a matter of fact, and sharing a division that they would not have shared in the 1970s because of realignment. When we added 32 teams, we moved the Reds and Pirates into the same division, just like they are currently. The Reds move out of the West, and they will actually be part of a more intense rivalry with a much more hated Pirates. This is probably the top rivalry in our timeline. Better than Yankees, Red Sox, Giants, Dodgers. Reds, Pirates, this is it. The creme de la crop. And the teams are reinforcing their claims to be the top teams in the league. Reds are getting more Big Red Machine 75 players on the team. Pirates still are trying to continue the 71 World Championship. Reds just got Joe Morgan in the offseason. Of course, let's take a look and see what's happened. Game one, opening up in Cincinnati. It is John Candelaria, a rookie, versus Fred Norman. And early on, the Reds make their move. They batter Candelaria in the second. A bench homer, a couple singles walk, an error, bad error by Hebner there. And then back-to-back doubles, Morgan Rose. That's six runs. That'll be more than enough today. 8-1 final. Fred Norman has a heck of a start, really. In the ninth inning, with two outs, Willie Stargell, not wanting the Bucks to get shut out, solo shot and a round of boos in Cincinnati, 8-1. So these two teams don't like each other at all. Game number two, the Pirates. They get the victory. Jim Rooker versus Don Gullett. They get an RBI single by Clemente. The Reds tie it with an RBI ground out. But the Pirates get the three runs in the sixth, a single walk, double by Zisk, a single sac fly, 4-2, and Jim Rooker goes the distance. He didn't need help from the great Pirate bullpen. Complete game, 9 hits and 2 runs. Gullett had a complete game, 8 hits, 4 runs. But Pirates beat the Reds 4-2 and get a split in Cincinnati. That's great news for your defending champ Pirates. But look what happens when we go. We head east to Pittsburgh. Game three, Jack Billingham making his first start with the Reds this year against Alan Foster. And the visiting Reds get a W. This is a low-scoring game. A solo homer by Foster. Two runs in the seventh, set up by a Stargell error at first base. We were moving Stargell from the outfield to first base, and that'll present defensive problems. In the eighth inning, Ramon Hernandez doesn't help the cause by walking three batters. They get to Billingham in the eighth for a couple, but it's not enough. Clay Carroll has an uneventful ninth to get a save. Reds reclaim home field that they just lost, 5-2. It is hardly surprising that the visitors have won two of the three games. These are tough teams, and so they have no problem going on the road to get a W if they need it. And that means we got a big game four coming up. I mean, and so much that it could influence the division title and even the playoff seeding. I mean, that's how important the Reds and Pirates are to the whole field in the National League this year. And game four, it is Gary Nolan versus Bob Moose, and these two starters deliver. Sixth inning, you get an RBI single by Tony Perez. It's 1-0, but the Pirates tie it with a sac fly in the seventh, 1-1. In the ninth inning, Moose and Nolan have hit their point of weakness. They have to exit. And it's Ramon Hernandez, who really struggled at the end of last year for Pittsburgh. He struggles again today, but it's not necessarily his fault. After a single, Bobby Tolan, homer 1-3, fly ball the rest. He would get the home run. That's a terrible break for the Pirates. But giving it away in the ninth inning is Clay Carroll with a two-run lead in the ninth. He gives up a walk, single, single, walk, and single. And it's a tie game again. So it goes into the 11th inning. Carroll and Hernandez get an opportunity to make up for their failures. In the top of the 11th, you get a walk, a Bobby Tolan stolen base off minus three arm Sangi, and that was a gutsy call. RBI single Rod Gilbreth, and this time Clay Carroll survives the bottom of the 11th. So let's look at the closer stats. Hernandez loses three innings, four hits, and three runs. Carroll, three innings, four hits, two runs, three walks, but Carroll gets the win. Hernandez the loss. 4-3 Reds. They are up 3-1. So, if you're keeping of a historical track of this, the Reds were the world champ. They got beat up last year, and they want some semblance of revenge. And the Pirates are trying to repeat, and they're showing the warts of how difficult it is to repeat in baseball generally, as you the competition is fierce. But when we take an overall look in this division, it really, grand scheme of things, there it is right now. I mean, it is completely up for grabs. So even though the Reds are up 3-1 in this series, you know, the Pirates, they win today, they flip-flop with the Reds in the overall standings there. So again, this is going to come down to the end of the year. And it doesn't look like the Reds or Pirates are going to be able to run away and hide from the rest of the National League. Moreover, you've got some nice starts by the Mets, who have a last-place schedule that helps them. Vegas is playing good baseball in a lousy division, so these teams are going to get lucky with better records, possibly. And even out west, the Giants are off to a hot start. So that's the problem the Pirates and the Reds, Cubs, Cards will face. They're going to beat each other up. So no one's going to be able to run away and hide in the National League from this division. Game 5. Reds would love to rip off three straight wins in Three River Stadium to get some revenge from last year. And we got a heck of a pitching matchup for you, folks. Don Gullett for the Reds. 17-game winner. 304 ERA in 243 innings. And your Pirates will send Jim Rooker. He won the only game. He beat Gullett in game two. Both guys coming back on short rest. Rooker, 15-game winner in 74, the 277 ERA. Basically, replicas of each other in the same year. I mean, I don't know who is better. You know, almost you could say it's a dead heat between these two guys. Gullett and Rooker. Gullett is only the number two starter because Gary Nolan, the Reds' ace, can't pitch on 3 days of rest. Let's get started. For your Reds, leading off, it is Joe Morgan, 2-8 grounds a second. Pete Rose, 2-7 grounds to short. Bobby Tolan, 2-11 rolls the first. Bottom of one, it's Roberto Clemente, 59, short X, but Concepcion's a 2E21, makes the play. Al Oliver, 55, second X. Joe Morgan's a 1E13. Reds flaunting their defense early. Manny Sanguian, 56, K's. Top of two, Johnny Bench, 2-7, is going to be a base hit. Tony Perez, 43, first X, and this is the problem we had yesterday, or a couple days ago. Stargell, 4E20 at first, and it's going to be an error. They Have Al Oliver, who can play center, but he's in center field to start the game. Two on, and it's George Foster. 2-7 is a 5-4-3 double play. Perfect timing for Rooker. Runner at third for Concepcion. 49 pops to second base. Reds missed a golden opportunity. Cashed in on the air. Pop Stargell, 65 off of Gullett, is a double. Richie Zisk, runner at second. 65 on the right side. Homer one, double. It's another one. Another two base hit, and your Pirates get the lead. One zip. Richie Hebner, 44, third X. Now you got Gilbreth, a free agent third baseman, a 318. Thanks to play. George Theodore, 48, center. And Frank Tavares, 210, is a base hit in the center field. You got to run Zisk. 11, 12, 13. It's going to be an 11. And he's thrown out at the plate. So, opportunity to go up by two, and it didn't work out. So, to the top of the third in a 1-0 affair. It'll be Rod Gilbreth. 69, second X. Then it's a 2E20. Makes the play. Bob Barton, 1-9 is a base hit. Joe Morgan, 34. Fielder's choice. He's going to steal. And he rolls a 1. And he T-rating, he doesn't get it. So he's at second. For Rose, who walks. 2-on-2 outs for Bobby Tolan. He walks. Bases are loaded for Johnny Bench. We've got to look at the card then, folks. He's only 24 years old with his second MVP award in 1972 and has hit 40 homers at least twice already. That is ridiculous. The greatest catcher to ever play, Johnny Bench. What a magnificent year. 270, 100 walks. Unbelievable. And a big moment here. Bases loaded, two outs. Here's the pitch. 3-5! Crushes it right on cue. I gave him the pump up talk. And that is one of the biggest swings of the 2024 season thus far. So far in the season, a granny by Johnny Bench. Now, if you're the Reds, you got to hold on to this thing. Grand slam home run off the shocked Jim Rooker. Hall of Famer Johnny Bench wanting to make a statement for his Reds. Ticked off from a year ago when they finished in last place. And they want to take care of business today. Tony Perez, 63, second X. Stennett's a 2E20, and he makes the play. All right, Pirates. Now they want to say, I get it. We understand it's Johnny Bench. I know, Hall of Famer, greatest player ever. But we are the world champs, so we are going to rally today. Down 3 against Don Gullett. It could start right now. Rennie Stennett. 110 flies left. Roberto Clemente. All these teams hate each other. 37. Single 1-7. Gets it. Al Oliver. 3-6. Triple 1-2. Triple 1-2. He gets a single dot down on the 3. Now, Sanguian. Runners on the corners. 1 out. Playing back. Manny Sanguian. 2-8. Double 1-14. It's a double. And they're getting the Gullett. Remember, I said how great these two pitchers performed. And now you're seeing that it's the batters taking their shots against them. It's going to be Stargell, their cleanup hitter. Let's see if he can replicate what Johnny Bench did in the top of the inning. 58. No, it's a strikeout. But you got second and third with two outs and Richie Zisk. 4-11, right X, but you have Tolan out, Foster out there today at 2-E-4. And it's a double off the rookie Foster. Technically not a rookie, but the first year we've had him in our league with a 75 card. Costly double, growing pains for the young Foster in this particular recreation. We got a tie game. My goodness, these two teams. And behind the plate, Johnny Bench is probably thinking, man, oh man, what do I got to do? 4-4, runner at second, two outs for Richie Hebner. Grounds the second. top of the fourth. George Foster, can he make up for his defensive mishap? Third X, Hebner's a 3-E-12. Base hit off of Hebner. Concepcion, 1-5. Base hit center field. Foster, 14. Does he go coast to coast? He's going to go coast to coast on a 14, and he's thrown out of third. Well, they were getting greedy. They were getting ambitious there, trying to get a runner at third with less than 2 outs, and he gets thrown out at third. Concepcion does still have speed at first with 1 out, and you got Gilbreth. 38 is single dot dot for Gilbreth. So you end up with runners on the corners with less than 2 outs anyway. And Rooker is clearly struggling. He's allowed 7 base runners in the last inning and so and change. It's Bob Barton. Infield's going to come up with 1 out. 1-8's a walk. Doesn't hurt yet. Boy, the running from coast to coast attempt is looking bad right now. Bases loaded, 1 out, Joe Morgan. You theoretically could play back, get a double play, and get out of the mess as Rooker really dominates lefties. So here's the pitch to Joe Morgan. 47 is a strikeout, and here it is, folks. It's Pete Rose. Let's take a look at him. Much better against righties than lefties, and the Reds are going to look pretty bad if they come out of this inning with nothing. Here's the pitch to Pete Rose. 67 off Rooker is single, 1-17. He gets it, and they retake a lead. That'll score Concepcion, and now you got Bobby Tolan. 46, skies are right. Well, we've had fireworks in this one, folks. Reds retake a lead 5-4. It's George Theodore in the bottom half. Ground ball to third plus injury. Well, now you got to move some pieces around. You just injured a player. Dave Parker will go into center. Stargell will go into left. Oliver will go into first at the top half of the inning. Frank Tavares, 1-7. Single, 1-17, gets it. Stennett swings away. 39 is a base hit because you had to hold Tavares. You got runners on the corners with 1 out. Bringing the infield up for Clemente. That's probably not going to work out, but they'll do it anyway. 45, ground ball second C. It does work out. So now you got second and third for Al Oliver. 3-11 hit by the pitch, and the bases are loaded for Mandy Sankey, and let's take a look at him. See if he can be the latest cast of heroes in this game. We've seen Bench. We've seen Zisk, Sanguin earlier, and Sanguin a chance to do it again. He had a 298 year in 1972. Here's the pitch to Manny. 290 delivers again. Triple, 1-2. Single dot dot. That'll retake a lead. Wow, folks. Runners on the corners. It's now 6-5 Pirates for Stargell. Hit by the pitch, and oh my goodness, folks, this could be a Donnybrook. Reminiscent of the Reds-Pirates Donnybrook before the All-Star game in 1974. Hit by pitch, there's some pointing, dugout's empty. All right, guys, we get it. We get it. We know the passion with these two franchises in this timeline. Gullit and Rooker both on the rocks in this one by these potent offenses. Bases are loaded, 2 outs, and it'll be Richie Zisk, who has a couple doubles already today. 2-7 is a strikeout. So, these guys have pitched poorly, but they've also gotten out of the damage in the fourth inning, where it could have been much worse. 6-5 Pirates. Already a bunch of fireworks. This is progressing like one of the most classic games ever. Into the top of the fifth. It'll be Johnny Bench. 1-5 is a walk. Tony Perez, haven't heard his name yet today. 1-6, skies the center. George Foster, been in the middle of a lot of action. Not a lot of it good. 2-9 is a 5-4-3 double play. Bad news there for the Reds. Bottom of the fifth. Let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Okay, bottom of the fifth. Gullett and Rooker, they're starter sevens and eights, and they're just going to hang around in this. Richie Hebner, 4'10", center X. It's Tolan today. They got Geronimo on the bench. Tolan's, though, a 2E4. Great outfield defense for the Reds. Probably the best in the sport behind maybe the Red Sox. Dave Parker, now in the seventh slot because of the injury to Theodore. 47's a K. And Tavares, who had the big reach in the fourth. 68's a walk. He's on for Stennett. 6'10", catcher's X. And this is bench of 29. So both Gullett and Rooker rewrite the ship. Into the sixth we go. Pirates have a lead of one, plus they sent three more batters to the plate in this game. Dave Concepcion, 58, flies a left. Rod Gilbreth, 110, short. Bob Barton, 47, pops the first, and now the pitchers are making a little bit of a comeback today. Top of the order, bottom of the sixth, Roberto Clemente, 17's a double. Al Oliver, 59, short X, Concepcion, a 2E21, makes the play. Runner has to hold it second. For Sanguin, having a nice day, 48, center. And with two outs, it's Stargell. And pops, it's a grounder to Morgan, but Morgan's a 1E13. And he boots a ground ball, Joe Morgan. Bad time for that. We've seen a couple goats today, mistakes by the Reds, Foster and Morgan. And now you let Richie Zisk, who already has two doubles today, come to the plate. Here's the pitch. 64 off of Gullett is gone! A three-run homer! Oh my goodness, the Pirates picking up after all the mistakes. And frankly, you take the bench grand slam away, and the Pirates could be in a rout right now. That is a three-run bomb off of the stunned Don Gullett. Does give up a lot of homers on this card. Did give up, let me just check it really quick, 22 in 243 innings. That's 300 runs, though. All off of the 1E13 defense of Joe Morgan. Really stunning. Now it'll be Hebner. 68, single 1-4, cannot get it. 9-5, Rooker. He's pitched well last few innings. He'll continue. Here is Morgan. 2-6 is a walk. Not going to steal when you're down four. Pete Rose. 37's a base hit because he shoots it through the hole where you were holding Morgan. You got runners on the corners. Rooker's a starter eight. He can't hit the point of weakness here. Two batters away from a potential Johnny Bench game-tying grand slam. Here is Bobby Tolan. 2-4 against a lefty is a 4-6-3 double play. Oh, wait a minute. No, they had eight bunters make the infield come up with a runner at third, so it's just a 4-3. And you have second and third playing back for Bench. And Bench strikes out on 2-9. And with two outs, it's Tony Perez. 57, a strikeout, Jim Rooker. Squashes the threat with some crafty pitching in the top half of the seventh inning for the Pirates, trying to get a win here at home. Down 3-1. Stretch time music. We've been enjoying The Intruders, 1973, Save the Children LP. Great record by a band often played on the radio in Pennsylvania, off the Gamble record label in this timeline. The Save the Children LP of 1973 for the Intruders. Bottom of seven, 9-5, Gullett. You know, I think maybe that's called a day. I mean, he's really surrendered a lot today. And Jack Aker will come on in the seventh. Long man, acquired from the Chi Sox, who put him on waivers. 6-6, 2.96 ERA in 67 innings for the Cubs in 72. He's the long man, and he'll face Dave Parker. 54, short X. Concepcion's a 2E21, and that's going to be an error on Concepcion. And now you got Frank Tavares. 45, short X. And now it's a single off of Concepcion. So the Reds just are not awake today. Too many mistakes. Foster, Morgan, two by Concepcion on back-to-back plays. Number 9 hitter, Rennie Stennett. 2-9, let's take a look at the Rennie Stennett card. And so much for a great game. This is turning into a mistake fest for the Reds, and the Pirates are going to run away with this one. Stennett in 75. Possibly the most significant part is his improved defense. He used to be a 4E41. Now he's a 2E20 at second base, and he's also hitting 286. 2-9, triple 1-10, and that'll empty the bases. It is now 11-5. Back up top to Clemente. 1-7, triple 1-11. That is another triple. And now it's time for the Pirates to rub it into the Reds' faces a little bit here. Al Oliver, 37, is right B question mark. Clemente versus Foster. He'll tag up. And I think he's thrown out. Yeah, he got thrown out at the plate on an 18. So that's a 9-9-2 double play there with a 7-run lead. Manny Sanguin grounds to short. Jack Ager was pretty awful. And I think Rooker, he's just going to take the afternoon off. He's throwing a lot of pitches today. And they have a 7-run lead. We'll go to Bruce Keeson, see if he can finish this game, the long man. Keeson has gone back and forth from starting and relieving throughout the whole decade, frankly. 9-8 and 74, the 3.49 ERA in 129 innings. They basically had their choice of Steve Blass and Keeson on this roster, and they understood that Keeson will last through the decade, and Blass is only one more year left. So we traded Blass to the Red Sox. So Keeson comes on in the eighth, and he will face George Foster. 66 is a K. Concepcion, 4-10, short X. This is still Tavares, a 3, it's short, makes the play. And Gilbreth, 49 is a walk. Bob Barton, 32, grounds the short. Bottom of the eighth, we'll go to Pedro Bourbon just to give the bullpen some work here. The Reds will want to win this series in front of their home folks, it would seem. Stargell leads off. 63, pitcher X, Bourbon is an E34. Not good fielding his position there. Richie Sisk, 69. What a day he's had. This guy's a center. Richie Hebner, 27, is a fielder's choice. And with two outs, Dave Parker started the game on the bench. Now this is his third at-bat. 35, a single on a 12. Lines out on a 13. They'll have Randy Moffitt come on in the ninth inning for the Pirates. A pitcher that they acquired out of the Giants system. Moffitt was 4-4, 2.43 ERA, and 73 for the Giants in 100 innings. Pirates have actually improved their defense from their World Series year last year. Top of the lineup, Morgan made an error, a costly error in this game that tilted the whole fiasco. 56, second X. It's the improved Stennett defense makes the play. Pete Rose, 110, is a single. Bobby Tolan, 57, is a K. And Johnny Bench, who has really made the only noise today. In the fourth, it seemed like it was going to tilt this series, but so much for that. Johnny Bench, 1-5, draws the walk, extends the game. Tony Perez having a quiet day today, hasn't gotten a hit. 59, bounces it to second base, and that's your Pirates finally getting a win at home in this series. Just the second win for the home team in 5 games. So we will have a game 6 from Cincinnati and a game 7 if necessary. We'll give you the results of those potential 2 games at the end of the video, so stay tuned. All right, baseball fans, here's the box score from the game 5 you just saw. A laugher, if you want to consider it that way. 12-5 Pirates. Rooker did enough to get a win. Reds made so many mistakes in this game. What a day for Richie Zisk. 3-for-5, a homer, 2 doubles, and 6 RBI. Sinking did nicely as well. So what's looking like just a violent series between these clubs in an unusual description. I'll take you to Game 6. Game 6 is not much of a baseball game. And this is the big red machine Reds destroying Pittsburgh after they were destroyed. 12-5. They win this one 17-5. And this is John Candelaria has a lot to learn about how to pitch against the Reds. Remember I said he got blown out in Game 2? It got worse. After Joe Morgan innocently flew out the right field to start the bottom half of the first inning, Cincinnati strung together 9 consecutive hits. 8 of those singles, by the way, with a double tossed in there. An error by Stargell is in there, a hit off his defense. A couple things. You know, Candelaria is just inning in a third, 13 hits, gone, 11 earned. Stargell at first base, I don't think it's going to work out. Or at least it isn't working out. So maybe Oliver needs to stay there and let Dave Parker play center. But this game got out of hand early and it was a disaster. And the Reds simply, you know, every 5-10 games, the Reds are going to just turn the cards over and just beat the pulp out of somebody and destroy my league ERA in the process. The carnage, 17 runs on 24 hits. I can't go through this game. It's just too much ridiculous things going on. I didn't see that Rod Gilbreth got 4 hits for the Reds. He wasn't even on Cincinnati, but in our replay, he got picked by them. 17-5, so what does this disgusting game mean? And was that the Reds did win this series 4-2. Well, we'll look at the standings again. You know, after splitting the last couple games, not much traction at all here. You got the Reds and Cubs technically tied for first, with the Pirates a half game back and the Cardinals a game and a half. So, again, this division is completely up for grabs. Digging into the stats now, the two pitching staffs are not looking good. Reds have a 480 ERA, Pirates 424. The team's hitting 285, 284. And it's just a case where you get two heavyweight fighters beating the pulp out of each other, and some other team in the National League is going to and might end up walking away into the World Series, shall we say. But in any event, give the Reds the prop. They were a last place team a year ago through stunning developments. They beat the Pirates 4-2. Thanks for checking this out. We'll see you next time.